Sounds like your assessment of Remy Duval was spot on. Listen to this.
Look at what he's doing to us. Our neighborhood, our homes. I, for one, refuse to sit by and watch as some rubber-lipped nigger runs roughshod over everything we hold dear.
And what is it you hope to accomplish?
I will strangle that motherfucker! That's what I'll accomplish! I apologize. Shouldn't use that kind of language.
He is egging you on, Remy. You are much too important to be caught up in all of this. Is the situation unfortunate? Of course it is. But nothing he is doing changes anything. Let Sal's men handle it.
Sal's men? Olivia, the people of this neighborhood expect me to protect them, not some greased-up wop assholes. No, 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 I need to respond to this. I need to send a message to those niggas and the guineas that here in Frisco Fields, we take care of our own.
This is a mistake, Remy. You could jeopardize everything we have been working toward.
Our very way of life is at stake, and you think I give a goddamn about some casino? Sometimes I think you've forgotten your station in life, Olivia.
A minute or so later, Olivia called Sal, told him Remy's Southern Union pals were out looking for you. If you head back up there, I'm sure it won't be long before you run into some of them, get them to tell you which hole Remy's hiding in.
Yeah, once I'm done with that prick, Olivia's next. Getting to someone like her ain't gonna be easy. Between Marcano's men and all those rich white assholes she runs around with, they'll spot me coming a mile away. I need you to look at our options. Come up with a plan.
Okay, I'm gonna look at our options and come up with a plan.
What's wrong with you, man?
Personal hygiene is very important.
See how they came waltzing in, dicked out in their fancy white robes?
My daddy used to say,
ain't that the goddamn truth? Too late. Fuck!
We stand here in the ruins of the last century. It was right in this spot where my great-great-great-grandfather joined his brothers in the defense of Louisiana against Northern aggression. Now, he died in this spot to protect the virtues and the values of his people. Gave his life.
now!
Have it your way.
A horrific scene here in Frisco Fields as one of the city's most prominent citizens, Remy Duval, was savagely murdered. Witnesses report he was bound to a cross and set on fire. Let's see if we can get a statement from the police. Chief Wilson, you care to make a comment?
It's those goddamn niggas. Every last one of them needs to be rounded up and shot.
That's quite a statement, Chief.
You need to wipe the shit out of your eyes, son. Take a look around. There's a goddamn war going on.
Olivia's at the country club. Get in. I'll run you through the plan. You're gonna love this. Marcano's having real estate problems.
I still don't understand why Olivia Marcano was involved in any of this. By all accounts, she had two or three times the money that Sal Marcano had.
Money didn't mean shit to her. From what I was able to piece together, she hired someone to kill Lucho. Wanted to run things herself. Bottom line, I think she got off on all that mob bullshit.
We're fucked, Olivia. You understand? That fucking shit-stained Duval didn't name us in the will. Now everything's going to his goddamn nephew.
Have you actually reviewed the will?
I read the part that said all the land I'm building my casino on is now going to Stephen motherfucking DeGamo. I read that part.
6 months ago, Remy revised the will, but he never executed it.
What the hell are you talking about?
In order for the will to be valid, it needs to be signed.
Well, goddammit, woman, I know that. What does it mean for us?
It means I have grounds to contest. Remy and I were business partners in several ventures, and one of my holding companies lists the land as an ancillary asset.
Sounds like a lawyer's wet dream. What's something like that gonna run me?
I haven't the slightest idea.
Nearly every cent I got is tied up in that goddamn casino. I can't afford a big legal fight. There's got to be another way out of this mess.
Stephen is coming to town for the funeral. I could arrange a meeting. Offer him a percentage of the casino's profits if he signs over the land.
Yeah. Yeah, that could work. And then once he signs, we take care of him. All right, set it up. But my patience is at its goddamn end. Do you understand, Olivia? I'm tired of this bullshit.
Have a little faith, Sal.
Now, Mr. Clay entered the country club disguised as a waiter.
Everyone in attendance was a rich asshole or part of the Southern Union, so getting Lincoln in there was easy. You put a black man in a uniform and he's damn near invisible. Hell, I drove in through the front gate and dropped him off. No one even gave us a second look.
No. Surely, his uniform wasn't enough to get him past Mrs. McConnell's personal security detail.
I mixed up a vial of fast-acting LSD. You know, same basic formula that we use as part of MKUltra. And I gave it to Lincoln. He used a syringe to put a couple of drops into every drink he served. Within a couple of minutes, anyone who drank that concoction was whacked out of their goddamn mind.
Fuck me.
What? What happened?
I never learned how to tie a bow tie.
You sure you're up for this?
Shit, I get in there and dose the guards with his military-grade LSD and get to Olivia.
Don't let those pricks goad you into anything. Remember, you won't be able to take any weapons with you. How's it going, buddy?
Follow the driveway up to the left.
You've got the case, the syringe is in there. And remember, the drug acts fast. It'll fuck up whoever gets a dose real quick.
Good. No sense in giving anyone time to figure out what's happening.
Let me get a look at you. If they kill you, at least they'll have something nice to bury you in.
Fuck you.
You see everybody else got here on time.
Them crackers put their hands all over everybody else.
Lazy nigga. That's their job.
Had me out there. Fucking asked me where I got my car. Where I'm from.
You best get in that uniform or get out of my goddamn kitchen, Claudia. Follow me. Get a rag on that counter. Looking like a goddamn rat's nest. Miss Olivia's gonna be out soon. She gonna say some words for old Mr. Remy. Can't stand a lazy nigga. Nothing low on the face of God's earth.
Yes, you can always tell.
Get one of those out there to them folks and serve them their drinks. And don't go talking to any of them, you hear? You ain't been... Get them folks their drinks now. Stop right there. Hold on.
Yes, I'm going down.
You ain't been paid to stand around, boy. Go serve them poor folks.
Drink up, motherfuckers.
So, do they have a suspect?
Not a one. Old Earl set to send some of his boys out to the holler, rattle some of them monkeys' cages.
I don't see it being one of the coloreds.
Fucking apes was never too smart, but you don't watch them. They get vicious real quick.
First, I'd like to personally thank y'all for coming to see our dear friend Remy Duvall off. I know with all of the... violence that has reached its way into our community, it might have felt safer just to stay at home or even leave town. But you did what Remy would have done. You held your head high and you didn't run away. It's not exaggerating to say that Remy was a brave man. But his bravery is not what I'll miss most about him. What I'll miss most about Remy Duvall is that he gave this city... No, he gave us a voice. The man who murdered Remy robbed this city of someone who honored its history. Not only that, Remy respected our shared Christian heritage, which extends all the way back to Europe. Remy was a dear, dear friend of mine. A dear friend to all of us. In the coming days and weeks, let's honor his memory by taking back our city, by preserving the way of life we hold dear. To Remy.
To Remy!
Hey, let them burn their bras. It makes it easier to see what they're working with.
Couldn't agree more.
We find
get
the
over
shot
here
who
without
killed Bobby,
man.
He's gonna wish he was dead.
Reginald, please keep your voice down.
What? Oh, he's probably one of the good ones. The fight? Nah, I didn't see it.
I want to watch two coons mix it up. I can do that anytime in the hollow.
If you say so. It's going to be okay, Cher.
Thank
you. Goddamn right.
Yes, he was a good man.
Hey.
I've never actually seen the nephew either.
I hear there's some money.
Maybe.
Spill it. What do you know?
Well... Let's just say there was a lot more to the Duvall fortune when his daddy died.
Oh my God.
God. She's gorgeous as all get out. But the woman
I mean, every last goddamn dime is gone.
Jesus.
What am I going to tell the other brothers?
We'll remind them to maintain white pride, brother.
My condolences.
Right now, it's the only thing the Southern Union has to its name.
Would have appreciated it.
The problem with that crowd is they've convinced themselves that being wealthy means that they have value. Look at me. I'm rich as Midas, and probably the least essential person on this block. The key to my happiness is knowing that.
Right. Thank you. Yes, he was a good man.
Dingo nigga.
Too many fishes in the deep blue sea for me to let you make a fool of me. I don't know what you're gonna do, but I'm gonna forget about.
Hey, new guy, you can smoke over here.
You see how Clarence is behaving? Looks like he's got a touch of whatever's going around out there.
Ask me, it couldn't have happened to a nicer fella.
Serves him right. Nigga this, nigga that. It's every other word that comes out of his mouth. Bad enough, hearing it from all these white folks, don't need to get it from one of our own.
Maybe after this, he'll rethink how he runs things around here.
That'll be the damn day.
I could give a shit, because they're all going to be white. Fuck them.
No doubt.
Hell with that, man.
Too many fishes in the deep blue sea for me to let you make a fool of me.
I'd think twice before going out there. Something's gotten into those folks. Something bad.
I don't care what Clarence says, I'm staying in here. Those people have gone crazy.
Finna cut that cracker. What was I saying now?
I just... I wish I could show you. It's all connected. You see? We, you, me, him.
Do you see light trails?
She gets on the mass.
Jesus.
Goddamn God.
Yes.
These people are out of their mind.
I see Remy. No.
Something is wrong. Get me out of here now.
Yes, ma'am.
I want additional men placed on the front door and around back. No one's allowed in or out without my say-so.
Should I say something to the guests?
Such as? You saw them. They've all come down with some kind of affliction.
What? Oh, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
That for Ms. Marcano?
Yeah. I mean, yes, sir.
Go on through.
Put it on the ball. Has DeGarmo signed yet?
No, ma'am. And they've been beating on him pretty hard.
Take one of his hands. See if that changes his mind. We need to get away from here before whatever is happening downstairs gets worse. I think our Negro friend here is a little dim. Won't someone get him out of here?
All right, big boy. Time for you to take a walk.
Follow me.
Geisha.
Precisely. The first time I saw Lucio, he looked so handsome. Dashing, even. He wore the finest suits, drove the best cars. There was always something terribly romantic about all of this.
Ain't nothing romantic about robbing and killing people.
Maybe not. But it certainly was exciting.
Where's DeGarmo?
DeGarmo. They have me out in a building. Down by the water. Thought you were gonna kill me.
You ain't worth the trouble.
Asking you a second time, boy. You the sign over that land, I swear to Christ, I will bust every fucking bone in your body. You hear me?
I'm not signing a damn thing.
Gamo, I'm gonna get you out of here, but we need to move. Marcano's probably sending more men.
Yeah. Okay.
Get him from the other side!
I think it's still there. Yeah. Oh, God. He's dead.
sucker must have hightailed it.
Go see what we're dealing with.
Did everybody ditch me?
Before they do, we're gonna die right here on this road. You hire something?
All units, negative visual on suspect. Repeat, visual contact lost.
God, please stop the car. I want to get out.
That's a bad idea.
Let me the fuck out!
How long you think you'll last out there? Marcano ain't gonna rest till he finds you.
He broke my hand! Shit! I just wanna go home.
I know. Listen, I got a friend. He's gonna keep an eye on you for a while, keep you safe. At least till things calm down.
Okay. Thank you. You saved my life.
Don't mention it.
Steven DeGarmo. Lincoln left him with me and I got him the hell out of there.
And you still know DeGarmo's whereabouts?
Like I'd tell any of you assholes.
Good morning, Miss Marcano. I'm here with your breakfast. Let's freshen this room up. Get some of that sunlight in here. That's better.
Are you telling me Lincoln Clay did not murder Olivia Marcano? He didn't kill women unless he had no other choice.
I find that very hard to believe.
Back in 67, we were in a bar in Saigon. And this gook bitch comes strolling in, skirt barely covering her ass, and she starts offering everybody blowjobs.
Gee, I want sucky fucky. Gee, I want a boom boom.
Then she pulls out a grenade and she kills three guys. A couple Marines in the bar want to cut that bitch's head off, but Lincoln stops them, keeps them off of her until the MPs show up. If he wasn't going to kill that slag, he sure as fuck wasn't going to kill Olivia Marcano.
Who'd you send?
I did it myself, ear to ear, just like you wanted.
Good boy. Leave us alone. I got business to discuss. I understand you supplied the heroin Georgia was selling.
Si, certo.
I never wanted that in my city. Shit like that fucks with people's heads. Makes them crazy. Stupid. It brings down too much heat. Bourbon?
No, I do not drink.
Georgie, tell you why I wanted to meet.
He said the nigger is causing you problem. That you wish to discuss a deal between the two of us?
I'm building a casino across the lake. I had it all set. Now the rights to the land are all tied up. It's a goddamn mess.
You won my money.
I'm gonna need enough to pay for all the blood-sucking lawyers, and that's not cheap.
I want to hear you say it.
Say what?
that you want my money. Say those words, please.
I want your money.
This is good. I will bring you the money. And in exchange, you will let me sell heroin in your city. And you will not interfere in any way.
Sure. Whatever you want. But that's not the only thing that
you... You also wish for me to kill the nigger? I will do that for you as well. I enjoy killing the niggers.
Jesus Christ.
That's where Sammy's used to be. No one wanted to live there, so they paved it over. Every now and then, something knocks the hell out of this country. Rattles it so hard, isn't much left but the foundation. And as painful as it is, we hope that this time, things are gonna be different. And that when it's time to rebuild, we won't just repeat what we've done in the past. And that maybe justice and peace will finally prevail. Justice and peace are hard, ain't it? Sometimes too hard. So we take the easy way.
No, stolen lad. Is this goddamn city finally ours?
There's no one left to stand in our way. We run this city now.
Asking my guys to lock down half this turf makes them anxious. Like, they don't know which side they're supposed to be cheering for. But giving us the entire turf sends a clear message. Tells them you're gonna take care of them.
You've got a 50-50 split of the rackets here, lad. Well, that's a mess made of your own doing. But I'll say this much. You came to me to run a part of the city last time. And I'd say it's worked out well for both of us. Do it for Danny Lincoln.
You got no idea how long I've been dreaming of this moment.
Gonna need Vito to run this turf.
Thanks, kid. Spent most of my life getting fucked by one asshole or another. And what we got going here is a real future. Ain't no one fucking with us anytime soon. I know none of this has gone quite as smoothly as we would have liked, but you've done something real over these last few months. Change this town in a major way. And I'm proud as hell of you. Fuck. Fuck! You know how long I've been waiting for someone to stand up and be a man of his word? And in all my fucking days, you, Lincoln Clay, are the first motherfucker to do it. Thank you. You've done a hell of a job, Lincoln. Couldn't have done a better job myself. Probably.
Cassandra was a hell of a woman. It's unfortunate she let her pride drag her down in the end. Failed to see the bigger picture. But I still admire her spirit. You did a bang-up job here, lad. A goddamn dream come true. Can't wait to see where we go from here.
Who'd ever thought I'd end up with you two motherfuckers?